Pompeys Pillar National Monument is located about 25 miles east of Billings, Montana. The monument encompasses 51 acres with a sandstone butte covering about 2 acres at its base and standing about 120 feet high, overlooking the Yellowstone River. Pompeys Pillar is a unique geological formation born of water. Sediment carried by an immense and ancient river was very slowly and forcefully compacted into rock, the same sandstone and siltstone visible today in the pillar. As subsequent rivers ebbed and flowed across the landscape, much of the sandstone in the area eroded. Fate or fluke of nature left this pillar of rock standing alone and isolated on the south side of the Yellowstone River. Due to its isolation and placement in the valley, the rock has been a landmark for millennia. It sits at a natural ford in the Yellowstone River. As a result, the area has been a crossroads of human activity from prehistory through the modern era. William Clark's inscription on the pillar is one of the surprisingly few remaining pieces of physical evidence still visible where it was left on the Lewis and Clark National Historic Trail. In addition to Clark's signature, the sandstone is marked with hundreds of other etchings and drawings. Most notable is the rock art, which is a vivid demonstration of the significance of the site to prehistoric and historic plains tribes. The natural forces of wind, rain, freezing, and thawing have been reshaping the pillar for thousands of years. Evidence of erosion can be seen at the base of the pillar, with the various rocks and boulders scattered below. However, recent examination of the rock formation has called for drastic but necessary action to allow visitors to continue to fully experience Pompeys Pillar. Due to the possibility of rockfall, there is restricted access to the staircase and boardwalk used to climb the pillar at Pompeys Pillar National Monument. The process of erosion has accelerated swiftly and now requires stabilization of portions of the rock, including the area containing William Clark's signature. In order to ensure Pompeys Pillar survives for future generations to enjoy, geotechnical engineers will conduct detailed three-dimensional computer-based analysis of the site. Analysis may include ground-penetrating radar, LIDAR, a surveying method that measures distance by illuminating a target with laser light and measuring the reflected light with a sensor, and pictometry, three-dimensional aerial photographs, for current conditions and identified locations. Engineers will also make recommendations and provide the design and construction documents needed to execute probable strengthening of the rock, a rock block monitoring program, and a rock scaling plan. After analysis and documentation, work will begin on shoring up the stone bones of Pompeys Pillar. In 2016, the BLM began investigating the stability of various parts of the Pompeys Pillar rock formation. An initial assessment entitled Pompeys Pillar National Monument Preliminary Site Evaluation Rock Stability, Formation Stability, and Drainage Conditions was provided by Dowell, a local geotechnical firm, and recommended implementation of proactive stabilization work. In 2019, the BLM contracted with Government Contracting Services and Geostabilization International to design and implement stabilization activities. As a result, they produced a report entitled Rockfall Mitigation Plans and Specifications. In preparation of the supporting environmental assessment, the BLM consulted with the National Park Service's National Historic Landmark Program. The Historic Landmark Program identified some concerns about the project as proposed and recommended review by their in-house geotechnical expert. The BLM convened a group of resource experts and program leads at Pompeys Pillar to review the project and discuss the proposal in person. During this meeting, the group identified a potential new risk through visual inspections. Following up on this discovery, Dr. James Mason, a National Park Service engineer, completed an analysis entitled Stability Investigation and Analysis with Recommendation for the Signature Block at Pompeys Pillar. In 2020, the BLM contracted with Itasca Consulting Group, Inc., a geotechnical engineering firm, to develop a three-dimensional geotechnical assessment of the pillar to determine how stable the formation is. This assessment will also lead to a more comprehensive stabilization design and monitoring plan. The firm will conduct an analysis of various rock outcroppings and will determine appropriate methods to stabilize the area and potentially remove loose material. Mitigation features will include inspections by a trained archaeologist or historian to ensure significant rock art will not be impacted by the proposed stabilization design. Implementation of the stabilization design is expected to follow soon. We want to ensure that the public has a safe and enjoyable visit to Pompeys Pillar National Monument. We presently do not have enough information that can tell us how stable the rock formation and rock outcroppings are. The 3D analysis will provide us with more information. The staircase and boardwalk at Pompeys Pillar National Monument will remain closed until the stabilization work is complete, and engineers believe the hazards have been resolved. While visitors will not be able to walk up the pillar, we have alternative experiences for visitors, including a video tour of the pillar, additional interpretive exhibits, interpretive programs, nature trails, picnic areas, and views of the Yellowstone River. We also have a video camera and monitor in the Interpretive Center for visitors to view Captain Clark's signature.